Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Vue Radio Button and Checkbox components. Radio buttons are typically used in groups where the user selects only one option from a list of choices, whereas checkboxes are used to make one or more selections, allowing users to choose between two options, checked and unchecked, for various purposes like selecting items or setting preferences. First, let's see how to get started with the Radio Button component. I will start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue Vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest versions of Vue and Node.js. I edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on a supported browser. To create a project in Vue, open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm create vite at latest. Then, provide the app name, my Vue app. Next, I choose Vue as the framework and JavaScript as the variant. The Vue project has been created. I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vite project. To add the Syncfusion Vue Radio Button component, install the Syncfusion Vue Buttons package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vuebuttons --save. This command will install the Vue Buttons package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, the application is ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To see how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion Vue components. To start using the Radio Button component, I open the app.vue page and remove the default code. Then, import the Radio Button component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Buttons package. Next, I am going to add radio buttons for the payment method in the online transaction page. First, I need to create a list for different payment methods. Inside the template, I add a list of 4 items. Within the first list item, add the Syncfusion Vue radio button using the EJS radio button tag. To set the button text, I set the label property to credit or debit card. To create a mutually exclusive group, define the name attribute and set an appropriate value, say payment. Similarly, add radio buttons to the other list items with appropriate labels. Here, I set the name attribute payment to all radio buttons so that when I select one radio button in the group, it automatically deselects the other radio buttons. Finally, I reference CSS styles to the radio button component by importing the material theme. I also add a few CSS styles to disable the visibility of the HTML list. I save the changes and run the application using the npm run dev command. You will see the Syncfusion Vue radio buttons rendered. Now, you can choose any one option from the list. To set any default value to the component in the code, use the checked property. To demonstrate, I set the checked property to true in the first radio button. Check now, the first option is selected by default. Notice, the button texts are rendered after the radio buttons. If you want to render the text before the buttons, use the label position property. To demonstrate, I set the label position to before inside the radio buttons. See now, the texts are rendered before the buttons. The Syncfusion Vue Radio button can be displayed in two different sizes, default and small. I will show you how to display a smaller radio button. Before that, I will remove the label position property for further demonstration purposes. To display a small-sized button, set the CSS class property to eSmall. Check now, the size of the buttons is smaller now. The default rendering direction of the radio button is left to right. To render it right to left, set the enable RTL property to true. See now, radio buttons are rendered in the right to left direction. Lastly, I will show you how to disable the component. I set the disabled property of the third radio button to true. Check now, the cash on delivery option is disabled. Next, let's see how to add the Syncfusion Vue checkbox component to a Vue application. The checkbox component is a part of the buttons package. As I have already installed it, I will proceed to add the component. I import the checkbox component module from the Syncfusion EJ2 buttons package. I comment out the radio button code snippets and add the checkbox component by adding the EJS checkbox tag. I set the label property to default. I have already referenced CSS styles for the button components. You can see the checkbox renders like this. To enable the checkbox by default, set the checked property to true. See the checkbox is checked while rendering. By default, the label renders after the checkbox. To change the position, set the label position property to before. You will see the label renders before the checkbox. Like the radio button, the checkbox also has two sizes, default and small. To change the size to small, set the CSS class property to eSmall. See now, a smaller size checkbox is rendered. Just like the radio button, it can also be rendered in the right to left direction. To change it, set the enable RTL property to true. To demonstrate the right-to-left rendering, I remove the label position property. Look now, the checkbox renders in the right-to-left direction. Finally, to disable the checkbox component, set the disable property to true. See now, the component is disabled. In this video, you have seen how to add the Syncfusion Vue radio button and checkbox components to a Vue application. You also saw how to customize the label position, size of the component, rendering direction, and disable it. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.